and welcome to Inside IAS. This is the last video of this year 2019. After that, new year will begin. And let's start with the first issue, that is Kalaripayattu, and it's a martial art based on the ancient knowledge of the human body. And it originated in Kerala during 3rd century BC to 2nd century AD. It's now practiced in Kerala and in some parts of Tamil Nadu. The place where this martial art is practiced is called a Kalari, and it is a Malayalam word actually, and that signifies a kind of gymnasium. Kalari literally means threshing floor or battlefield. The word Kalari first appears in Tamil Sangam literature to describe both battlefield and combat arena. It is considered to be one of the oldest fighting system in existence. It is also considered as the father of modern Kung Fu. To learn this, lots of people come from outside world to Kerala especially. And the next issue is Pulicat Lake, and it is famous for Flamingo Festival. The annual Flamingo Festival is to be held in January at Pulicat Lake this year. And the Pulicat Lake supports rich biodiversity and high biomass of fishes and planktons, which is utilized as food resources by visiting birds. Thus, about 75 aquatic and terrestrial bird species visit the sanctuary every year. It is the second largest brackish water ecosystem in the country after the Chilika Lake, Odisha. Guys, in comment box mention which is the largest freshwater lake in India. So, and also mention which is the largest inland salt water lake in India, and also mention which is the highest lake in altitude wise in India. And this is located on the border of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. We are actually discussing about Pulicat Lake, and it covers over 96% of it in Andhra Pradesh and 4% in Tamil Nadu, the largest portion in AP. The large varieties of birds like grey pelicans, painted storks visit the site annually. This grey pelican and painted stork both are near threatened species under IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. Next issue is Directorate of Revenue Intelligence. The Ministry of Finance has released a postage stamp to commemorate the distinguished service and glorious contribution by the Directorate of Revenue Intelligence in protecting the nation. The DRI is the apex anti-smuggling agency of India, working under Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, Minister of Finance, Government of India. The Central Board of Excise and Customs was renamed as the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs in 2018 after the rollout of Goods and Services Tax. CBIC deals with the tax of formulation of policy concerning levy and collection of customs, central excise duties, central goods and service tax, and integrated GST, prevention of smuggling, etc. So it is taxed with detecting and curbing smuggling of contraband, including drug trafficking and illicit international trade in wildlife and environmentally sensitive items, as well as combating commercial frauds relating to international trade and evasion of custom duty. So the DRI has also been designated as the lead agency for anti-smuggling national coordination center, and it was constituted in 4th December 1957. Next issue is National Anthem, and why it is in news we'll discuss. On December 27, 1911, the National Anthem was first sung at Calcutta session of Congress. Janaganamana was adopted as the country's national anthem by the Constituent Assembly of India on January 24, 1950, the last day of its last session. Actually, our Constituent Assembly adopted the Constitution in 26th, India adopted the Constituent Assembly in 26th November 1949, and it came into effect in 26th January 1950. So this reverence to the national anthem is a fundamental duty as per Article 51A of the Constitution. Originally written in Bengali, It is the first of five stanzas of a poem written and later set to notations by Rabindranath Tagore. Then the next issue is Western Dedicated Freight Corridor. The Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India Limited has opened the more than 300 km section between Rewari, Haryana to Madar, Rajasthan for commercial trial runs. This is the first section to be opened on the under construction 1500 km Western Freight Corridor. This is the region, here is your Rajasthan, here is your Gujarat, and this is the portion of this Western Dedicated Freight Corridor. And it is a broad gauge corridor. The 1504 km Western Freight Corridor begins at Dadri in UP and stretches till the country's largest container port, Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust, near Mumbai. And passing through UP, Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat and Maharashtra, also covers some portion of Maharashtra and also Gujarat, Rajasthan and Haryana. So, the project will be funded by a soft loan of $4 billion provided by Japan International Cooperation Agency under special terms for economic partnership. And it passes through Vadodara, Ahmedabad, Palanpur, Phulera and Rewari. The project will eventually be linked to the Eastern DFC to form four hubs known as Indian Golden Quadrilateral, including Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Guys, in comment box mention who was the mastermind behind Golden Quadrilateral, including Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. Because recently the Good Governance Day was celebrated and in that light it was in news. So you guys might have aware about that properly. The DFC corridor will run only freight trains. The construction of Western Dedicated Freight Corridor project will enable the decongestion of existing oversaturated path, which thereby will effectively improving punctuality of passenger trains. Then discuss Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India Limited. The DFCCIL is a corporation run by Ministry of Railways India to undertake planning and development, mobilization of financial resources and construction, maintenance and operation of the dedicated freight corridors, etc. DFCC has been registered as a company under the Companies Act 1956 on 30 October 2006. Guys, a question can be like this. Infrastructure is the backbone of Indian economy. Discuss the measures taken by government to boost infrastructure development in the recent budget. Let's move to the next question, next topic, that is Nari Shakti Puraskar. To acknowledge women's achievements, the Government of India confers Nari Shakti Puraskars on eminent women and institutions in recognition of their services towards the cause of women empowerment. The awards were initiated in the year 1999. The Ministry of Women and Child Development announces these national-level awards for eminent women organizations and institutions. The Nari Shakti Puraskar carries a cash award of 1 lakh rupees and a certificate for individuals and institutions. Let's discuss the previous year questions, and it will be much more beneficial to us. In this way, we will be discussing all those questions which were asked and very important from prelims point of view. So, it was asked in prelims 2014 with reference to India's culture and tradition, what is Kalaripayattu? Options are, it is an ancient bhakti cult of Shaivism, still prevalent in some parts of South India. It's a wrong statement. It is an ancient style bronze and brass work still found in southern part of Coromandel area. It is wrong statement. It is an ancient form of dance drama and a living tradition in the northern part of Malabar. It is a wrong statement. And it is an ancient martial art and a living tradition in some parts of South India. It's a right statement. Like Kalaripayattu, we have other martial art forms are like Gatka in Punjab, and after that, Pike Nach in Odisha, after that, Mushti Yudh, that is famous in UP, that is especially Varanasi. And in this way, you can remember some 10-12 martial art forms are there, and Thangta in Manipur also, I remember now. And in this way, please try to mug up those, and it is very important from prelim point of view. So let's move to the next question, which is asked in prelims 2019. Consider the following statement about particularly vulnerable tribal groups, PVT disease in India. So, options are, let's discuss one option and try to eliminate others. So, option 3 provides, there are 95 PVT diseases officially notified in the country as so far. So, actually 75 PVT diseases are there. So, it's a wrong statement. In this way, you can eliminate option A, option B, and option D also. So, right option would be C. Even if you know only one option, you can make it correct. So, try to develop this kind of skill especially, and doing multiple questions. That's why we are every day we are providing six questions, so that your approach and your kind of knowledge base also, with that how to eliminate the options, that will increase. So now onwards, try to solve the questions. So the other options are, PVT disease reside in 18 states and one union territory. It is the right answer. Highest PVT diseases are there in Odisha and second highest in AP, and in population wise highest would be in Madhya Pradesh. A stagnant or a declining population is one of the criteria for determining PVT status. It is the right option. And Irular and Konda Reddy tribes are included in the list of PVT diseases. It is also the right option. So that's it for today. Thank you guys. Have a nice day.